With off-canvas, instead of stacking content vertically, the off-canvas pattern places less frequently used content, for example navigation or app menus, off-screen, only showing them if the screen is large enough. On smaller screens, the off-canvas content is typically shown when the user taps on the hamburger icon. Let's take a look and see how it's done on the Web Fundamentals site. In narrow viewports, the navigation menu is hidden until I click the hamburger menu. In other cases, the off-screen content may actually come in from off the screen. In this sample page, the content is coming in from the left. But in other cases, it could come in from the right. Let's take a look at the code for this example. I have two elements, the dark blue nav and the main content in light blue. In order to make sure the elements take up the full viewport width, I need to set the width on HTML, body, and main to 100%. Next, I'll set the styles for the off-canvas nav element. I'll set a specific width of 300 pixels, being careful to keep it reasonably sized so it doesn't overflow the viewport. I'll use translate minus 300 pixels to move it off the screen and add a transition of 0.3 seconds so that it animates in nicely. When I want it to appear, I'll add an open class that resets the transform. Now, I'll add a breakpoint at 600 pixels that repositions everything back to its normal spot. The media query at 600 pixels resets the transform. Adding flex grow 1 to the main element allows the element to grow and take up the full remaining width of the viewport. Let's give it a shot in the browser. When the viewport is small, the navigation panel is hidden until I hit the hamburger menu. But on wider viewports, it's shown by default. Nice.